Right.
The Europeans almost decimated the entire Jewish community.
Right.
They felt guilty after the war. Well, so they came, and they were very gracious enough to give the Jewish people Arab territory called Israel, and they decided it's Israel. So they supplanted these European Jews, right. Ashkenazic Jews, from Odessa and from all over Europe, and they said, here's Israel. So the Arabs are saying, "It's not. There was no Holocaust here. We didn't murder right. you. So why? It's very nice of them. Like, they should have given you Germany or parts of France or parts of London, England. Why do we have to suffer?" So those who propose two states, they think that they're solving a problem. They're only exacerbating the problem. Because the real question is not if a Jew belongs in Gaza or if a Jew belongs in the West Bank. The real question is whether a Jew belongs in Israel, in Jerusalem, in right. Tel Aviv. Because what the Arabs are saying is you don't belong here. So the moment you say two Palestinian states, what you're telling the Arab is, yes, we're occupiers, we stole your land, we have no right to be here. So the Arab's saying, really? And you want to give me Gaza, a West Bank? You live in Gaza. I want Dizengarf. You keep Gaza. My grandfather lived in Jaffa. We're only exacerbating the problem. The issue is, do Jews belong in Israel or Jews don't belong in Israel? Are we in Israel because of the UN, because of Balfour? And the answer is, we can tell the world the secret. Everyone knows the real reason why we're in Israel. Not because of Balfour, not because of the UN. Let's share with the world the secret. We're in Israel because the creator of heaven and earth, he chose Israel as his home. And he said, this is where I and my chosen people, my bride, I love all the nations of the world. Just like we all love, we have friends and we have best friends, but we have one intimate partner. And this is my bride. So God says, I'm going to live with my bride in this holy land, in holy matrimony forever and ever. Israel does not belong to the Jewish people. It's not ours. It's God's. We are guests in this royal palace. Right. So how dear. Imagine a guest giving up the kings, your hosts, giving up his dining room and discussing negotiating his bedroom.
Right. Well, which brings me to my next question, really is, assuming that we're talking about that this is a divine gift from God to the Jewish people, which everyone believes in the Bible, and the Bible is godly. It was ordained by God to give this land to the Jewish people. You're saying we don't have the right to give it up because it was ordained by God.
But then again,
we have to preserve life. So let me play devil's advocate over here.
Okay.
If we have to preserve life. And we have the situation where the Arabs are here, and they're saying, you know, well, it wasn't our problem. The Holocaust wasn't here, et cetera, et cetera. How do we deal with that?
Let me paint you the following scenario. You're at home, and someone comes into your home and starts throwing stones at your wife and your child.
Right.
And he starts claiming that home is his. Now, how would you respond? If someone comes and threatens the life of your loved ones in your own home.
You'd call 9/11.
Right.
Unless you believe that he's right. I really don't belong here. Maybe it is his, not mine.
Right.
The problem is not the Arabs.
The problem is the Jews.
The problem is us. We've met the enemy and it's us. We are not acting normally or naturally.
Right.
We're behaving as if it's not ours, as if we occupied anything. When the Jewish people stood at Mount Sinai, where a large majority of the world were cannibals, we're uncivilized. We stood at Mount Sinai and God told us, thou shalt not steal. How dare anyone suggest that we stole anything from anyone?
Right.
This is our home. Act like it's your home. We are very gracious. The Arabs want to live here with pleasure. But act like a mensch. The moment you start acting and you start advocating murder and you start preaching murder, that individual is out of here.
Right.
If you want to live a productive life and follow the seven Noahide laws and live a righteous life and educate your children and provide for your children and lead a productive life, we're more than welcome. They're treated better than any Arab country. But it's our home. And there's nothing to negotiate and there's nothing to discuss.
I agree. And that's something which I think Israel has not focused on, that really that when we don't have to give up our home and we don't have to make concessions, and if they're willing to live in peace, there's no reason why they shouldn't be living in peace.
Well, the rabbi is so right about the fact that we are our own worst enemies because we're acting guilty, you know, after 67, instead of saying, oh, well, we won this war. Where it was a defense.